Hi there, welcome to the channel. My name is Alana and I'm the creator of the Health Analytic Insights podcast, where I interview guests and talk all things health informatics. In this video, I'm going to give you three unconventional tips to breaking into the health informatics field and acquiring that first job. Getting that first job in health informatics can be quite difficult, and it's definitely something that I struggled with. And this could be for a multitude of reasons. But some of the reasons that stick out in my mind is for entry-level positions, and this is not just unique to the health informatics field, many entry-level positions are advertised as entry-level, but they require 1 to 2 years of experience. And for new grads, this can be really frustrating because you get into this chicken and egg situation. You need the job to get experience, but the job requires experience. So that can be really frustrating. In addition, the health informatics field is quite a fairly new field, and so there might be limited positions in your area. Depending on if you live in a big city or a small city, this might affect the number of healthcare organizations or hospitals that you have in your area, and therefore this can have a direct correlation with the number of health informatics positions that are available. So saying all this, let's get into the tips, and I hope these tips can help you get your first job. So tip number one, if you're a new grad and you don't have co-op or internship experience, consider creating your own portfolio or project highlighting your technical skills. So for instance, you could create a portfolio or project that's focused on a clinical problem. It might be something like highlighting patient readmission rates in a hospital and focusing on which factors are most key in resulting in a patient readmission rate. And you can highlight technical skills which are often advertised in health informatics roles, such as experience with SQL, experience with R or Python, experience with data visualization tools, such as Excel, Power BI, Tableau, Qlik, etc. And so you can document your steps using these technical skills in a GitHub account and then link to this on your resume. So when you get an interview, you'll have something to talk about. If you don't necessarily have that internship or co-op experience, you'll at least be able to showcase that you have understanding of these technical skills and you've carried out a project using them. Tip number two is to grow your network. Although networking can have sometimes a negative connotation, can sometimes seem slimy, the long-term benefits of having a strong network which you've built through authentic connections can't be understated. So how do you go about doing this? What I would do is start with a Google search, look at health informatics events in your area, look at Facebook events in your area, and also look at meetup.com, search health and technology, and see what type of events pop up. Even though, you know, we're still not in face-to-face events, there are still many online virtual events that are happening, and they do have built-in networking opportunities where you can have one-on-one conversations with people who might have given presentations. You can ask them questions about their research or their interests and really start to develop those connections. And this can really be beneficial in the long term when it comes to job referrals, because sometimes it can feel like you're just throwing your resume into the dark void of LinkedIn and Indeed, and you don't know how things are progressing. But having that insider knowledge in the form of a job referral really is beneficial in obtaining that first job in health informatics. Now, the last unconventional tip I have when it comes to getting that first job in health informatics is to volunteer for your local chapter of your health informatics organization. And so some popular health informatics organizations for in the US would be the Health Information and Management Systems Society, or HIMSS for short, and in Canada, Digital Health Canada. When it comes to volunteering at these large health informatics organizations, it really is a symbiotic relationship. You volunteer your time to help prop up the organization, and in exchange, you can really be exposed to people who are at varying levels of their career. You can meet mid-level to senior professionals in health informatics, and this can even result in a mentorship opportunity down the line. In addition, One of the benefits of volunteering at health informatics organizations is that it might give you early access to certain jobs that might not be posted on LinkedIn or Indeed, because vendors might post their jobs on these health informatics organizations because they know they're going to get a very tailored group of candidates. So that might even give you early access, or at least an understanding of what these job postings look like for the field of health informatics. So I definitely suggest, you know, taking time to volunteer at these health informatics groups, because you never know what the long-term benefits could be. So these have been my three tips to breaking into the field of health informatics. So to recap, tip number one is to create a project or portfolio that you can showcase in an interview situation, showcasing your technical skills. Tip number two is to grow your network authentically by attending events that are focused on the health informatics field. And tip number three is to volunteer at large health informatics organizations and develop connections with people who are further along in the health informatics journey. So I hope these tips have been helpful, and I'd love to hear from you. Comment down below, where are you in the journey of obtaining your first job in health informatics? Also, don't forget to check the description box, because I will leave a free guide to starting your career in health informatics. Thanks, and have a wonderful day.